Let's see, Lorraine. What do the spirits have in store for you today? What? I'm seeing something.
Is it a man?
Well, I'll be darned. It is. Oh. Do you know a Bill?
No.
How about a Bob?
No.
Jack?
No.
Mike?
No.
You don't know anybody named Mike?
No.
Girl, you gotta get out of the house more. Lucky for you, I'm running a special on love potions this week.
Oh.
Now, for only $99.95, you can get my special deluxe love kit guaranteed to give you a lifetime of matrimonial bliss with the man of your dreams.
Who will take it?
Ooh, smart girl. And, wouldn't it be worth an extra 20 bucks for him to be faithful?
Definitely.
Now, what you do, Miss Wiesner, is you drink this little bottle of love potion, then you get naked, and you dance around this little red candle like crazy until you work up a real good sweat.
Ew, not a pretty picture.
Oh, Renfield, don't be so catty.
What?
Oh, I was just talking to the cat.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, you do this every night until Mr. Wright windsurfs into your life.
Oh, Elvira, how can I ever thank you?
Next time, bring cash.
Hello?
Hello? I'm back. Come in. Careful of the step.
Minerva? What the heck are you doing with that shopping cart?
Oh, don't worry, dear. I'll send it right back to the store.
Minerva, what have I always told you about exposing yourself?
Oh, dear. Did I tuck my skirt into my pantyhose again?
No. I mean exposing your witchcraft.
Oh.
Come on, you know the rules. As long as you don't do it in public, you can do it as much as you like.
Or until you need glasses. Oops. Too late.
You shut up, you furball, or I'll have you neutered again. Elvira, I hate living in the closet.
Look, I don't like it any better than you do, but I'm sick and tired of pulling up stakes just to keep from getting burned at one. Besides, I like living here in Manhattan.
Oh, yes, glamorous Manhattan. When you told me we were moving to Manhattan, I thought Broadway, Times Square. But no, you meant Manhattan, Kansas. The Little Apple, the city that always sleeps.
The main thing is that nobody's caught on to the fact that we're witches, and I'd like to keep it that way, okay?
Well, it's not as if we were Siegfried and Roy. I mean, we can only do a few harmless parlor tricks, moving shopping carts, fixing parking meters, switching price codes.
You can switch price codes?
Of course. Look, I got this family-sized jar of chunky peanut butter for only 25 cents.
Did you get my shaving cream?
I knew I forgot something.
Oh, great. I'll just spread this on my legs and let the rats chew off the hairs. Now, can you please take this shopping cart back to the store?
Well, can I at least ride in it?
Minerva?
I'll push it.
Oh, Minnie, bring back some kitty litter, or you'll be sorry.
This machine does everything. Dried fruits, jalapenos, bridge mix, and pressed meats. But this five...
Look at that, Renfield. A five-tray electric food dehydrator. Imagine, we could make hundreds of pounds of beef jerky.
Stop, I'm grueling. Switch it back to Sharon the fat lady.
Minerva, get the door!
I'm coming. Hold your horseshoes.
Hey there, pretty lady.
Renfield, did we order a hunky stud muffin from the home shopping club?
Who is that? Oh!
Excuse me, but which one of you is a psychic?
I am. I really have to excuse my aunt. She's getting senile. I was going to put her in one of those homes, but you know how they mistreat the elderly.
Okay, you can have him. I had the insurance salesman.
So, you must be Elvira.
No, I must be dreaming. And you are?
Chip. Chip Taylor.
Oh, Chip, as in potato? Bet I can't eat just one. Walk this way. Dock your dinghy, sailor. Let's see. Oh, Chip, I see big things in your future.
Really?
Yes. Would you like to see more?
Yes, ma'am. But actually, what I really came here for was friends of mine told me that you sell love potions, and I'd like to buy one. How much is it?
I don't know. How about if I just lip wrestle you for it? Minerva, get the door! Hold that thought, Chip. Right between your knees. Put me down for 2 boxes of chocolate mint and 1 vanilla cream. Thanks. I thought you didn't have to pay till you got the cookies.
I can see that you're busy.
Busy? Whatever gave you that idea? See? I'm completely free. At least for the first 3 minutes.
How about if I just come back tonight?
Tonight. Groovy. Yeah, I'll come back tonight and I'll give you my happy hour special. 2 for the price of 1. Are you still here? What do you want?
My name is Paige Grayson.
Yeah, so?
I'm your niece.
On my knees? I ain't getting on my knees for no Girl Scout.
No. I'm your niece.
Chocolate mint and 2 golden nut clusters.
Minerva, this young lady in the clunky shoes seems to think she's related to us.
You must be Paige. Oh, darling, I'm your great aunt Minerva. Oh, let me look at you. Oh, my, how you've grown.
But you've never seen me before.
Well, I'm assuming you used to be much smaller, didn't you?
Wait a sec. Who is she?
She's Elvin's child.
But my brother never told me he had any kids.
He didn't know it himself. He died before she was born. Her mother disappeared a few years ago in a mysterious boating accident in the Bermuda Triangle. Poor dear Paige. She was raised by nuns on a remote island off the coast of Maine. Now she's come to stay with us.
Oh, that just explains everything.
It wasn't until I turned 18 that the sisters warned, told me about you. This is the first time I've ever been away from boarding school.
Oh, so that's a uniform. Oh, thank God. I thought you just had really bad taste.
The sisters taught us not to dress in a way that could tempt men to sin.
Well, let that be a lesson to you, dear. Never take fashion tips from a nun.
Mother Superior would never approve of that outfit.
Hey, opportunity only gives you knockers once.
Paige, darling, come. Sit down and tell us all about yourself.
Yes, what do you like to do for fun?
Well, I like to clean.
Well, then this place ought to be one big non-stop party for you, girl.
I hope so. I've always dreamed of having a happy, normal family life. Sunday drives, playing Scrabble by the fire, setting up a lemonade stand in the front yard.
Oh, and you can be June Cleaver, and Minerva can be Ward, and I'll be the Beaver. Minerva, she's way too straight to be one of us.
You're right. Sometimes the gift can skip a generation. We'd better find out.
Okay, but remember, be subtle.
Subtle is my middle name.
So, Paige, when did you consummate your union with the incubus?
Minerva said she always gets constipated when she rides the bus. Minerva, remind me to make you that appointment with Dr. Kevorkian. So, Paige, you know, my brother was quite, gifted. Surely you must have inherited some of his talents?
Yes, I did. I can speak Latin and play the accordion.
Where? Our Lady of Perpetual Polka?
Listen, Paige, why don't you just run on upstairs and take a nice, long, hot bath?
All right.
If she floats, she's a witch. If she drowns, our troubles are over. Officer Taylor is here to see you.
Show him in.
Officer Taylor reporting.
Thank you, Maxine. That will be all.
Uh-huh.
Hey there, pretty lady.
Don't you pretty lady me.
Ooh, chip. As in potato? But I can't eat just one.
Well, I guess I don't have to ask if the wire worked.
Officer Taylor, in case you forgot, your assignment was to nail her.
Believe me, there is nothing I'd rather do.
Chip, I don't want you going back in there alone. That love potion she sold Lorraine Wiesner put her in the hospital. What if she drugs you and takes advantage of you?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, that would be terrible.
You just remember, Chippy. I'm going to be listening to everything that goes on tonight. And if you're not out of there by 10 o'clock, I'm sending in the SWAT team.
Come on, carpet. Say ah.
Oh, going somewhere, dear?
Very funny. I've got a date with Chip tonight, and I plan on getting rug burns on every square inch of my body.
Okay. I finished cleaning the oven. But I'm still waiting for the freezer to defrost.
Oh, you can finish that later, Cinderella. Right now, you and Aunt Minerva are going out to have some fun. So just run on upstairs and change clothes.
I did.
Oh, yeah, the rubber gloves are a nice touch. Let's see. There must be lots of fun things for you guys to do in this town. Look! The future farmers of the Flatlands are having a cakewalk and corn shucking contest.
That sounds like fun.
Well, actually, I'm rather tired. Why don't you go shuck yourself, dear?
Minerva!
Okay, okay. Come, child. We are going to paint the town gray.
And Minerva! Ixnay on the adjectmay in front of age pay.
Yeah, app cray.
Oh.
entree.
Hi.
Oh, Chip, I wasn't expecting you so soon. And look at me. I'm a mess.
I think you look pretty cute.
Oh, bet you say that to all the ghouls. Sit down and make yourself comfortable. Oops. Can I get you a beverage?
Oh, you mean a drink? Oh, sure. Well, how about that love potion?
Oh, Chip. Why would a handsome stud like you need a love potion?
Well, sometimes I have, a problem.
Oh, problem. Oh, that kind of problem. Oh, well, I think we could fix that with a little physical therapy.
That would be great, but how about the love potion first?
Well, okay. I'll get the potion. Then you get the notion. Ow! I wonder if this is going to be strong enough. I don't know how big his problem is. I know. I'll just add a little extra starch. Here we are. A nice, big drink.
Thanks, Elvira. What do I owe you?
Oh, it's on me. And after you drink it, you will be too.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to take it to go. You see, I have a date.
A date? Chip, no. Let me see your hand. Oh, no, Chip. She's all wrong for you. I mean, she's all sweaty and wrinkled and calloused. Take my advice. Drop her like a hot potato, Chip.
You're making it awful hard on me, but I really gotta go. Have the potion back, please?
No. Why should I, you two-timer?
Hey, give me that.
No!
Give me that!
No!
Give me that!
No! Chip! Chip, are you okay? Chip! Gosh, he's hard as a rock!
Well, wasn't that the whole point?
Wait a minute. What's this?
Timber!
Oh, my Godzilla. He's a policeman. What am I going to do with a big, stiff cop?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, my God. They're back. I can't let Paige see Chip like this. Curly.
They ran out of cakes. Aunt Minerva won them all. It was incredible.
Just beginner's luck.
There's more in the car.
Minerva, look at this. It's Chip. My love potion turned him stiff as a board.
Well, wasn't that the whole point?
He's an undercover cop.
Oh, my goodness. You could get the chair for turning him into a table.
Minerva, you gotta do something to loosen him up.
Well, how about a martini and a massage?
Well, maybe later, but right now I think we ought to do something about Chip.
Wait a minute, let me see. Reverse the spell from this lovely madam. I command thee now, up and atom.
It's working! It's working!
Uh-oh, I think I put too much up in his atom.
Wait, I know the refrigerator's finished defrosting, so I have some place to put these.
What are you doing?
Oh, just a little redecorating.
Really? Here, Aunt Minerva.
Devil's food, my favorite.
How do you explain this?
Oh, well, Paige, you know how I like to pick up men?
Believe it, but it's true. Both of you, you're witches.
Witches?
Us?
It's no use. She's on to us. Okay, what are you gonna do? Turn us in?
No. I just don't want any part of this. I'm leaving.
Well, break out the champagne and little frisky.
That's enough out of you, you nasty old cat.
Hey, you heard Renfield talk?
Yes, so?
Only a witch can hear animals' thoughts.
Paige, you're one of us.
No, I'm not like you. I want to be normal, like everybody else. I hate being different.
But what's wrong with being different? Look where it's gotten me. No, what I meant to say is, you're the only you have, and if you're not going to be you, who is going to be you? Who? I don't know. I was just trying to make you feel better. But I wouldn't be trying if I didn't really care.
And we do, dear. Very, very much.
Attention! This is District Attorney Lindsay Olsen Weinberg!
It's the cops!
I'm out of here. Ciao.
Get me, you dirty coppers!
Minerva, what is the matter with you?
Nothing. I just always wanted to say that.
You see what I mean? Using witchcraft causes nothing but trouble. Minerva, take Paige and sneak out the secret tunnel. I'm turning myself in.
Into what?
3 seconds! Just remember, Paige, I'm not just doing this for you, but for our kind everywhere. And all the other freaks and misfits who dare to be different. Because if I have to live in a world where everybody is forced to be the same, well, they may as well just lock me away. Because I'll already be living in prison.
You have to reverse the spell. Do it.
Chip! Oh! This is a bust.
No, this is a bust.
You're under arrest.
For what?
For selling Lorraine Wiesner a potion that put her in the hospital.
But that was just some plain old herb tea. Okay, well, a couple of toenail clippings.
Tell it to the judge.
Oh, ELviRA, what are you doing?
Oh, probably 8 to 10, thanks to you, Lorraine.
Miss Wiesner, I'm glad you're here. Now you can officially press charges against this woman for poisoning you.
But I wasn't poisoned. I got pneumonia from dancing around a candle naked.
But I can still arrest her for selling phony love potions.
The love potion worked. If I hadn't have been hospitalized, I never would have met my fiancé, Dr. Marvin Zislis.
We just dropped by to say thank you for making Lorraine sick.
It was my pleasure. But why don't you come back later when I'm not tied up? Now, get me out of here or I'll sue you for penetrating my civil rights.
Well, let her go.
Chip, how could you have kissed that trash?
Hey, honey, at least trash gets picked up sometime.
Look, ELviRA, I'm real sorry about all this. No hard feelings?
I don't know. Maybe later.
Would you like another piece of cake, dear?
Ugh, no. If I have any more cake, I'm gonna blow up like a poison dog in the sun.
Paige, this tea is delicious. What's in it?
Oh, just some things I found in the pantry.
Which things?
Yes, they were.
No, I mean, what's in it?
Oh, it's just herb tea. Oh. And some toenail clippings.
Whoa.
No, it was a joke. I think.
Almost, dear. But you're learning.
Yeah, before you know it, we'll have you flying around here in a pointy hat and a pointy bra.
She was just walking down the street singing. Popping her fingers and shuffling her feet singing. She looked good, she looked fine. She looked good, she looked fine.
Scream. You won't be able to take your eyes off of Elvira's Haunted Hills.
Allow me to present Elvira.
Yeah, nice meeting you too.
Elvira!
Entertainer extraordinaire.
See Elvira stretch herself as an actress in her most challenging role.
I just love butterflies ever so much.
And her most revealing.
Hey, what are you doing? You want to blow the rating on this picture?
Since, that last movie she did.
Jeez, everybody's a critic.
Richard O'Brien, in his most horrifying performance since Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Oh, why? Why? Why?
Well, snap out of it. Now, what are you going for, an Oscar?
You will witness the nightmare of a woman scorned.
Oh! Oh! Ouch.
A film that is so steamy.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
So titillating.
Lucky for you, I come equipped with my own airbags.
So shocking.
That's another unfortunate Elzebub's family trait, catalepsy.
Fear of cats?
It's a masterpiece for all time.
It's time for bed.
Mm. It's time to send you back to hell.
It's time for la douche.
You'll scream. You'll laugh.
Nice jacket. Who shot the stove?
You'll wet your pants.
Damn, I hate when that happens.
Elvira's Haunted Hills.
My slutty, adulterous darling.
Hey. Don't call me darling.
From the masterfully macabre mind of Elvira.
Right, like there's something going on in my mind.
Elvira's Haunted Hills.
The village people say this castle is evil.
Yeah, who listens to the village people anymore?
Fright Night picture hosts. And probably the best known today is a woman who's on TV here in the West particularly, in other areas too. She's the mistress of the dark, Elvira. And here's how she opens her show each week. To be a lesson to all of us. Anyway, she's come in to scare us all to death in person. I've just been told, ladies and gentlemen, Elvira. Good. Just send your postcards to this side of the screen, ladies and gentlemen, rather than. Anyway, Elvira, it's great seeing you. Little did I realize what that would mean. I understand that during the tapings of your shows, which we just saw a little bit of there, you have had some embarrassing moments. In fact, some that were really scary.
Well, I'll tell you, Steve, when you do a show like mine and you don't have a big budget to spend, it's a one-take situation. Mm-hmm. Know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, now, sometimes when you don't get it right the first time, it is not only embarrassing, but it hurts. I am telling you, if I was them, I would be thinking twice about jumping right back in that Volvo of theirs and making sure... Oh! When I do my show, I try to create the right mood for my viewers, of course. Mm-hmm. I like to come across kind of sexy, mm-hmm. sinister, and above all, poised.
Well, hello, darling. Yes, it's Movie Macabre, and I'm that gal with the shape that drives men ape, Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Welcome back to good old...
Now, Steve, I know you may not believe this, but this is not my real hair.
All right. It's my real hair, ladies and gentlemen.
But on my show, I always try to look my best and make sure it looks natural.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I can just see the headlines now. Woman killed in bathtub by a deranged rubber ducky. Oh, she went up. Ah!
Well, Steve, I've had my share of embarrassing moments, I guess.
Yes.
But none was more disgusting than the one you're about to see. Now, I was introducing this horrible horror movie where a giant leech falls from the top of this building, see?
A little yickety creature.
Yeah.
Of some kind.
Yes. And luckily, it lands on a woman's umbrella.
Mm-hmm.
So we had a little fun reenacting the scene with a piece of liver. By the way, this is not for the squeamish.
Boy, I am telling you, that leech looked like a big old liver to me. It just looked like a big old liver.
Wait a second, darling. I think it's going to rain. I better get under my umbrella.
Well, Elvira, thank you so much for joining us tonight. And we'll be looking for your show around the country. Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, watch your show.
Rare, kind of, and hard to find. This is my beautiful dress I had made by Jane Book. This was originally a dress that I wore around. I wore it to a party one time, just this part. And I later used it in Haunted Hills. We had this really gorgeous, long, flowing robe. It was a cover that I think was a gift to me to put my script in for the movie Mistress of the Dark. So it's what I kept my script that I read off of every day to remember my lines. This is a little costume that we had made for Elvira's Haunted Hills. This is kind of an interesting thing. It's a lobby standee for movie theaters all over the country. And the interesting thing about this that you won't find anywhere else is that we have a brownie here lighting the fire. She's roasting marshmallows over it. And what happened is that we were told by the Girl Scouts of America that we couldn't use a brownie in a picture. And all of the ads and standees and cards and everything from then on, Edie McClurg, who played Chastity Pariah, replaced the brownie for legal reasons. I know, hard to believe. My letter from Elvis Presley that he wrote to me the night I met him, with all his little notes that are very kind of spirituality based. So this letter is a big deal, and it's written on just what he found laying there on his coffee table, which is a letter to his father, Vernon Presley. So that is a very, very big deal for me. These were used in the 2017 Not Scary Farm show where I drove my macabre mobile out on stage and took them off. And down here, this is pretty awesome because this is the original steering wheel that we had on the macabre mobile made by the prop department of NBC. This is an ELViRA Santa suit along with the boots and the belt that I have worn more times than I could possibly tell you for everything. This is my little metal outfit that not only did I wear as a costume in the early days, early 80s at Not Scary Farm, but it was designed by my friend Robert Redding. Over here is a really fabulous dress designed and created for me, especially by Michael Schmidt, who is a fantastic designer, designs for a million and one different singers and celebrities. And he made this with there were a million little worker bees putting on these Swarovski crystals. This thing weighs a ton. But he had to make me a costume that looked similar to my costume from Mistress of the Dark. We wanted to get the same vibe. And so I wore this in the last show I did at Not Scary Farm because I twirled tassels. So we had to make a tassel twirling bra again and a costume that would work for the finale. So it was the big finale number of my finale show at Not Scary Farm. There's interesting things in this case.
One I love that is one of my prized possessions is the picture from Queen, who I met and hung out with, and signed by Freddie Mercury and all the band members to me, long before I was ELViRA. Another one is an original Robert Redding, my friend Robert Redding did a cartoon of ELViRA. It was the first thing we did. We put it in my personal newsletter. We were so excited about it. And then the license plate from the car and the dashboard ornament from my original macabre mobile made by NBC Universal for Mistress of the Dark. This was the original license plate border that was on the car. I had to take that off when I bought the car too because couldn't weren't allowed to have it on the car for whatever reason. And also the little instead of having Jesus on the dashboard, we had a Grim Reaper. So there's the original one and only Grim Reaper that was on the car in the movie. This is a really important item because this is one of three original dresses. It very well may be the first original dress. I see that the bra inside has faded terribly. It used to be black. It's faded to some kind of weird gray flesh color. But I know this is the original, one of the originals, because it was made out of very, very thin polyester when I first started. As time went on, the fabric got thicker and thicker. So this is positively one of my very first dresses. And this is the one and only original first belt. Still has a letter pin. Robert found this at a department store, and it was my first belt I wore on Movie Macabre. So later we began having them made, and we used an actual dagger in them. But this is the one and only first belt ELViRA ever used, along with this dress. These are my very, very sad-looking original ELViRA heels that I bought at Fredericks of Hollywood. they got a lot of wear, let me tell you, because I thought I was going to be able to get more pairs as time went on, but Fredericks of Hollywood discontinued this shoe. And I loved it so much and wanted to keep the very same look that we ended up having more shoes like this made.